everyone, Christina Werner here. Welcome to another video for SimonsSystamp.com. Today I'm going to be using the brand new collaboration set for Stamp Timber from Concord and Ninth. This is the Monster Hugs stamp set, and I'm going to start out by stamping the monster and this little greeting that says "This sucks" in some black ink onto watercolor paper. The black ink I'm using today is a VersaFine Onyx Black. This is a waterproof ink, so it's going to be perfect for doing some watercoloring over the top of this little scene here. So this monster here, he looked a little bit sad, a little bit melancholy, and the greeting that says "This sucks," I thought went really well with it. It's kind of funny. So it reminded me of the Tim Holtz Crazy Bird stamp set from a few years back, where I made this card and I drew on a little deflated balloon, and so it made it look like this bird was going to a party and missed someone's birthday. And so I thought I would do something very reminiscent of that, using the same idea with the deflated balloon. And that original card with the bird actually is what prompted Tim to ask me to make the accessory set for the birds. So you can actually buy a stamp that's similar to this with a deflated balloon. But for today, I just drew it on here with a pencil and then went over my sketch lines with a waterproof black pen. This black pen is the Pilot Envelope Addressing Pen, and it's really great because it's a really fine line, and yet it's waterproof. So if you want to do any additional detail work or any little sketching ideas on top of your watercolor pieces, you can use this pen, and then you're able to watercolor over the top. It's a really great one to have on hand, and because it's waterproof, it's great for addressing envelopes, hence the name, an envelope addressing pen. So something different that I added onto this scene here that I didn't do on that bird card from 3 years ago is I added some little confetti that's on the ground. So it looks like the party's already happened. This little monster totally missed the birthday. And it also gives me the opportunity to color in all those different pieces with different colors. The monster is only going to have a few colors on him, and the balloon will only be one color, but I really want to make it look like it was a party at one point. So adding those additional colors at the bottom will give it that look. So I've got a split screen going right here just so you can kind of see what I'm doing off to the side. I'm taking my Distress Ink mini ink pads and pressing them down onto a slick surface. This is a palette from Art Impressions, and it's really great for picking up color from any ink pads that you might smush down, or even if you want to use it with watercolors, it's a great mixing palette. So I'm starting out with shaded lilac, and I'm going to drop in some lighter shades of purple all over this monster. I'm going to leave some areas completely white so that there is a little bit of a highlight. And then I'm going to bring in some worn lipstick on his cheeks, and I'm also going to use that same color on his belly. So he looks a little bit pink and purple. Thought it was really cute. I dried that with my heat tool very quickly and then came in with some Seedless Preserves. This really intensifies that purple color. I love Seedless Preserves because it has kind of a raspberry undertone. It's really, really nice. I then took Dusty Concord and added some more intense purples. For the balloon, I'm using the color Cracked Pistachio, and I'm emphasizing the shading on that with a little bit of Chipped Sapphire. As far as the colors go for the confetti down at the bottom, I used a little bit of mustard seed, some picked raspberry, and just some of those other purples that are on the monster, and also the cracked pistachio. I added a ground to this scene using some pumice stone, just a little bit of that gray shade. And then for the background, I wet the entire area with just clean water. This is so that as I drop in colors, those colors can really mix and meld with each other. So I did the background with a couple different colors. I used cracked pistachio. Actually, no, this is evergreen bough. Evergreen bough and chipped sapphire. Those were the two colors that I used for this background. So after it was completely painted, I used my heat tool to heat set this. And not really even heat set. It doesn't need to be heat set. It just needs to be dry. And then I removed the tape from the board, and I was able to move on to the rest of the card. As far as the greeting goes to finish this entire kind of "I missed your birthday" type of thing, I cut off a little strip of black cardstock and then used a number 8 Jelly Roll white pen to write "I missed your birthday." The number 8 width of pen is actually what used to be the original Jelly Roll size. So I like to use the number 10 for more bold lines, but this number 8 is great for writing little messages on cards. The card base is made out of some Fog cardstock from Simon, and I just scored that at 5.5 to create a side folding card. I then adhered that watercolor piece down with some foam tape, and that card is completely finished. I wanted to mention that I did create an envelope to go along with this card, and you can see that over at my YouTube channel. I'll have it linked in the top corner, or if you're at the Simon blog, it will be linked down in the blog post below. Thanks so much for watching, and I will catch you guys in another video very, very soon.